For tens of thousands of students within the Douglas County School District, there are still so many unanswered questions about what school will look like this fall.
After more than 3 hours, the school board approved a plan to reopen schools.
And Denver 7's Addie Guajardo tuned into the virtual meeting where a plan was laid out, questions were raised, and recommendations were taken into consideration.
Preparing for the fall school year will require an extensive guideline. So let's crack open the plan the Douglas County School District Task Force presented on Tuesday, a framework.
This motion passes 6-1.
Approved by the board, despite a lack in clarity and details.
I'm just very unclear as to the advantages of putting this in a resolution.
But with the understanding the recommendations are subject to change based on health expert and government input. If all goes as planned, this is what you can expect. Families can decide if they want their students to learn in the classroom or online. Students will undergo temperature checks, maintain a 6-foot distance from each other, and eat lunch in the classroom to avoid large gatherings. How many students will be allowed in the classroom? Well, that's not clear. Per executive order, gatherings within a school building is limited to 10 people, including staff. The plan laid out increases the burden on teachers.
We will have to identify staff to help support the e-learning. That is terribly unfair to ask a teacher to do the in-person and then support the e-learning.
Getting to school on the bus will look and feel different. Under the current guidelines, only 9 students will be allowed on a bus with a 77-person capacity, which means they must cut routes. The task force is recommending getting approval to increase capacity and looking at third-party companies. Mask use in schools is recommended, but as a teacher brought up during public comment, it could be a hindrance to deaf and autistic students.
A face shield for all staff would provide a full visual support for students with a hearing loss. A face shield would also help students who receive speech therapy, could also benefit students with autism.
Now, I can't stress this enough. This plan is subject to change, but now that the framework has been approved, they can nail down some of those details they didn't really have on point today, and they can flesh those out. Now, we did have a lot of questions, but we didn't have the opportunity to ask them. But we will keep pressing them and bring you the latest details. Reporting live, Addie Guajardo, Denver 7.
Yeah, we're all figuring this out. Thank you, Addie.